Actress Sridevi remains India's most beloved and enigmatic movie idols. She was called India's first female superstar. It's going to be 4 years on Feb 24th since her death in Dubai, but her fans and family around the world are still struggling to gain closure. But who was Sridevi? Indian author and journalist Satyarth Nayak tries to decode the mystery and mystique behind the award-winning actress in his latest book, Sridevi, the Eternal Screen Goddess. We are in conversation with the author before his session at the Emirates Literature Festival this Friday, and we talk about the highs and lows of encapsulating Sridevi's tremendous journey in his book.
I was always very fascinated about it. I think when you write a book on someone, it is because you're so absolutely in love and fascination with that person, with whatever that person is. I went and met Boni sir regarding the book. This was in 2017. This was when she was alive. So, you know, I was the first to approach Boni sir then. Because 2017 is also a milestone career in Sridevi's life. It was her 50th career in cinema, and Mom was her 300th film. So for me, I thought it was the right moment to actually do a book on her. I mean, what a great milestone. Yeah, so I spoke to Boni sir about that, and he was extremely excited that yes, let's do a book that captures her journey. He spoke to Sri, and she was interested at that point of time, but also she told me, let's wait for a year, because Janhvi's movie is about to release, Dhadak. So she said, once Dhadak is out in 2018, August, that was supposed to come out, once Dhadak is out, we shall then, you know, get started on the book. So that was the original plan. Then of course, 24th Feb happened, and suddenly, you know, she was no longer there, and I was in an absolute shock that how do I now do this book without her, in her absence? It just seemed an impossible task. But a friend of mine told a very beautiful thing. He said, you know, you owe this book to her. So do it, because you had promised this book to her. The only difference, he said, would be that now your book will have a last chapter. So that made sense. So I kind of picked myself up again, let's do this book. So I met Boni sir again. I already had Penguin backing me, because they were, right from day one, they were very excited to do this book with her. So then Boni sir said, okay, then just go and let's just do this the way we had planned. And that's how the journey began. I was very sure that this book should not be a hagiography, like so many biographies tend to become at the end of the day. So while one is fascinated. I mean, ultimately, you talk about Sridevi. Let's just face it. So, you know, there's only so much bad that you can talk about someone like her, who is almost great and flawless in everything that she does. But having said that, there were definitely aspects of her career that I have been critical about. I, from day one, had it in mind that this needs to be the definitive biography on her. I was very clear about that. For example, which is why if you see the book, it begins with her southern career, which is something that very few people know about. Prior to coming to Bollywood in 1983, she had a 2-decade-long career down south. And what illustrious career, with stalwarts like Rajnikanth and Kamal Hassan, and, you know, in Telugu cinema with Chiranjeevi and Nagarjuna, and the kind of directors. Even now, people down south feel that she had much better roles in Tamil cinema than she got in Hindi, and which is true to a certain extent if you see her Tamil and Telugu work. Also for me, very important was that Sridevi, when she came in the 80s, you know, she was one actress who broke the hierarchy that was there. She challenged patriarchy in a big way in Bollywood, because 80s was not the kindest decade for actresses in Hindi cinema. How she became a force to reckon with, how she became bigger than all the heroes, which again was a very new phenomena in Bollywood. So an actress becoming so powerful that she could call the shots in, you know, in a studio. So all of that, I wanted to be very clear in the book, that journey, how she inspired a whole generation. I mean, when she passed away and all the obituaries that came, everyone was like, thank you, Sridevi. You inspired me to be a woman. And that was because of the way she conducted her career and her life. So that for me was a very important and integral part. I think that for me, that's the biggest takeaway of this book, that how she empowered women among them. I get that a lot as well. The moment you know that you've written a book on her, the first thing is asked, you know what happened in Dubai? Yeah. I get that asked a lot as well. Yeah. So, and I definitely wanted answers, because that had to be the last chapter, and I wanted some kind of a closure that I could. So I spoke to Boni sir, I spoke to people that she was close to, and they've all given me a reason, which is there's nothing dramatic, nothing salacious about what happened, which is the version that I have got. And these are people who are credible voices, you know, these are, whether it's a family, whether it's someone like Nagarjuna, who is such a credible superstar and credible voice down south, or a director like Pankaj Parashar, who directed her in Chalbaz, you know, those are people who have spent time with her, who know the kind of health issues that she was facing, and they have spoken about that, they voiced their concerns. Like, for example, Pankaj Parashar told me that when they were doing the film with her after Chalbaz, on the first day of the shooting, she did not turn up, and they were all waiting for her on the set, and then news came that she had fainted in her bathroom. And so Pankaj told me that when I heard about her death, I immediately, that that memory immediately came back to me. So she had always had low blood pressure issues, throughout her career, and fainting spells were something that was very common to her. And like I said, this is not an investigative book where I go and investigate what happened. This is a book where, for me also as an admirer, I wanted a closure like so many of her fans. And since these are credible voices telling me a story about her health issue, I put that in the book, which is what you will get in the book. And I really sincerely feel that is what we should leave it at that, and we should not really investigate, because I don't really think there was anything dramatic or melodramatic or controversial or anything about that. But I think what happened was a very unfortunate accident. And you just have to leave it at that. This is a book that really talks about not just the star that we know and we love, but also the woman, the person that she was behind that persona of hers, and how she battled patriarchy, how she came to industry that was ruled by men, and then how she became the number one star, and how she started eclipsing her male heroes, like I said. That for me is a big, big takeaway.